That's not quite enough musical con day two. I'm gonna need a little bit more than that. Now listen, we're about to have a very special presentation from Cameron McIntosh Limited. All of the performers that you will see are very dear to all of our hearts. These shows are dear to our hearts. So one more time, let them feel the love. Musical Con, y'all are special. It's good to be back here with you today for day two. Are you excited? I said, are you excited? Well, let me welcome you today. So the four Cameron McIntosh shows currently playing in the West End are Les Mis, Mary Poppins, The Phantom of the Opera, and a show that is very special to me, Hamilton. Now we are bringing you a taster of each today with some very special guest appearances. So, up first, Les Miserables. Now in its 38th year, Bublé and Schoenberg's legendary production of Les Mis is playing at London's Sondheim Theatre and on tour in the UK, currently playing in Canterbury. The magnificent score of Les Mis includes the songs I Dreamed a Dream, On My Own, Bring Him Home, One Day More, Master of the House, and many, many more. Yes, seen by over 130 million people worldwide in 53 countries and in 22 languages, Les Mis is undisputedly one of the world's most popular musicals. So please, welcome to the stage, Jean Valjean himself, Mr. John Roderick! Now, John.
Yeah.
John, before you share your gifts with these lovely people, before you share your gifts, I'd love if you could tell us a little bit about your history with the show, because it's very unique, and the roles that you've played through the years, the friendships that you've made, please.
Yeah, I mean, I can't get enough of the show. I've played three roles in it. I began in 2008 at the then Queen's Theatre, which is now the Sondheim, playing Marius with more hair and less gut. and then directly after that, I was Enjolras on the first incarnation of the new production on the 25th anniversary tour. Did anyone see that tour in 2009-10? Yeah. And then I have, for the last 3 years, including the little break that we had,
yes,
been playing Jean Valjean at the Sondheim Theatre.
Yes. You've truly like had the opportunity to kind of like test the waters here and there, keep leveling up, keep changing it up, and you've kept freshness with the show, and with yourself as well. Absolutely.
Well, I feel like the show has so much meat on the bone,
that there is
stuff to explore in every role. And because the show is so rich, every single cast member has a character name. No one is, unlike Hamilton, man one, man two, man three, they're all Claxou, Bamatabois, Conferac, they're all character names, and the book is this thick.
Yeah.
So there's so much that you can mine out of this show that really doesn't ever get boring.
Of course, with that type of detail, you get a different depth of character, you get a different depth of storytelling that I think comes across, and it's one of the reasons that Les Mis has been such a standpoint of the greats of musical theater for so long. Well, let me ask you, what's your favorite thing about still, after all these years performing in Les Mis?
Well, One Day More never ever gets old, ever. I'm not gonna do it by myself, by the way. Although that would be entertaining, wouldn't it?
Absolutely.
Right, I need 8 volunteers. No, kidding. hands straight up. I don't know how many times I've done the show. I think it's probably somewhere around 1,500 times.
Must be. Easily.
And One Day More never, ever, ever gets old. The end of that number, the way it's written, the way that all the characters come together, it's perfect. It's a perfect act ending.
It's untouchable. It's one of the things I know for myself, and I'm sure for a lot of people, it's one of the things the first time you heard it as a young MT fan. It's this thing that kind of like cements itself in your mind.
Even people like Lin-Manuel Miranda credit One Day More. I mean, Nonstop and One Day More are the same thing.
It's a similar. It's even in the South Park movie.
Yeah.
There's this ode to One Day More in the South Park movie. What would be the end of Act One in the film? Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah, it's a perfect song.
That never gets old.
No, absolutely. Well, speaking of never getting old. Please enjoy Bring Him Home by John Robbins.
Should we do that? This is a no phone song, so if I just kidding.
John, would you mind joining us and having a seat and hanging out?
Thank you, everybody.
Do you want to hang out? Do you want to hang out? One more time for Mr. John Robbins! John, you are forever and the utmost professional and one of the cornerstones of the West End. I much love to you, brother, as always. Absolutely. Now, please put your hands together and welcome to the stage. And Horace himself, Jordan Shaw!
I'm joking.
Good morning, baby.
Good morning.
I wanted to chat a little bit. You know?
Yeah,
I wanted to chat a little bit. So tell us about the character, how you prepare for the role, what it feels like. Like, give us the lowdown.
Honduras is an absolute dream role of mine. I've wanted to play this role for such a long time, so I feel like I was kind of like mentally preparing myself for many years just in case I got the opportunity to do it.
Yes.
Andres is a leader. He's an educated man. He's had experience with combat, but I like to lead with love with my fellow students, my friends, my brothers. And I think that a show like Les Mis, it has so much heartache and pain and sadness, but there's such passion and hope. And I love drive with that.
Yeah, I think I couldn't agree with you more. I think the hope and the love is the thing that kind of keeps the show, keeps the audience caring too, as well as the characters. It's that looking for what's better and what's after.
Exactly. There's so many people that come to watch the show so many times and they go and say, "Oh God, I cried again and I cried again." And you wonder why. It's because you've got to have that moment, that feeling of like, Are they gonna win? Are they gonna live?
Of course.
As you know, they don't. No one knows.
Yeah, spoiler alert if you haven't seen the show. There's something really, really important that you have brought to the role, and that has been reflected because you've recently won the Black British Theatre Award for the role.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
What an honor. And you are the only man in Les Mis history to win for that role, to win any award for that role. You're the only man in Les Mis history to win for that role. So one more time, please, for Jordan.
Thank you so much for being here. Thank you.
So now, the Black British Theatre Award is something that's been very important for our community.
Absolutely.
So what does winning this award mean? What has it meant for you?
Oh, gosh. I mean, well, when I was coming up and I was training, I started training when I was 6 years old to do musical theatre. It's always been a hobby before it was a career of mine.
Yeah.
So if I was a little black boy growing up and going, oh my God, I could possibly be nominated and win an award.
Absolutely.
That would have just changed my whole outlook and my hopes and dreams. It would have been such an aspiration of mine. So for me to be playing a role that I never really thought I would be able to play in a show like Les Miserables, and to be recognized for it and to win an award, God, it really does feel like a dream come true. And my number one goal for anyone coming to watch the show is to see that musical theater, it's a dreamland. We can do whatever we want with it, and we can make it and change it and twist it.
Yes.
And a show like Les Mis that's been running for 37 years, into its 38th year, we can have a different lens of what we expect of the show.
Absolutely.
So I feel truly honored to be a part of that change.
I think the audiences should feel honored to get to see what you do with the role. And I think the way that you continue to elevate it and elevate the craft is important. And it's important that representation genuinely matters and makes a difference.
Absolutely.
Coming up as well, I was probably 7 or 8 as I was getting into musical theater. And like you say, it starts as a hobby. And the more times that you're able to see people who look like you excel and rise above is phenomenally important. So please give it up one more time for Jordan Shaw.
Thank you. Have an awesome day. This is incredible. I'm so excited this is happening. Thank you. Nice to see you.
Would you mind having a seat as well? Enjoying John over there? Because we have one more guest. We have one more guest coming out. Please welcome Eponine herself, Nathania Ong. They really did you dirty. They really did you dirty on that one. the help. The same spontaneity of live theater here with you all for Musical Con, you know. Anything and everything will happen. Nathania, how are you this morning?
Oh my gosh, I'm so good. I'm even better now. That's kind of blown me up a little bit, hasn't it?
Yes. Although, I'm going to ask you first, how does it feel playing such an iconic role at what is really the birth and beginning of your professional career?
I think I really, first of all, feel so blessed because I don't think I could have ever imagined being in this position, you know, seeing to all of you today, wow. Just that little girl in Singapore, didn't really do musical theatre as a child, did mostly singing, and then eventually kind of like worked my way up and got interested in acting and all of these things, and I was like, I like singing and I like acting, why don't I try both all together and try musical theatre? And, you know, kind of did the little steps, and now here I am.
Of course, well, we're all very lucky that you did all those steps, that you were willing to combine your two loves to create something. Well, let me ask you this. What is like your dream role, or more than one? You can name more than one. What are your dream roles? If it's something that hasn't been created, that can be that too. Just free slate, what's your dream roles?
I think I'd love to try lots of new things. Like, I think there's so much work that just hasn't been done yet. But I think, as of currently, I would love to try Veronica and Heathers. But I guess we'll see. I don't know. Make it happen.
Sign me up. Anybody else on board with that? I thought so. If you wouldn't mind, Nathan Yong is going to sing On Your Own for us. So please, take it away. Oh, there's more of you now than there were about 15 minutes ago, I see. How's everybody feeling? Is everybody like, well, let me ask you this, because we have something very special coming up. And I think if anything, there's a running theme of dreams coming to fruition and magic, and magic is in the air, you know? I can feel a little magic in the air. Can you feel a little magic in the air? I said, can you feel a little magic in the air? Well, that's good, because up next, Mary Poppins. Starring ZZ Stroud in the title role, Charlie Stemp as Bert and the legendary Petula Clark as the Bird Woman. Disney and Cameron Mackintosh's magical story of the world's favorite nanny is triumphantly and spectacularly brought to the stage with dazzling choreography, incredible effects, and unforgettable song. Brilliantly adapted from the wonderful stories of P.T. Travers and the original film, this magical musical has a book by Oscar-winning screenwriter, Downton Abbey creator Julian Fellowes. The timeless score includes the classic songs Jolly Holiday, Step in Time, and Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Now this is important, and ZZ and Charlie will tell you, because I was messing that up backstage. It took like 3 tries and I did not get it, but I got it that time. And of course, Feed the Birds with new songs and additional music and lyrics by the Olivier Award-winning British team of George Stiles and Anthony Drew. Mary Poppins is flying out of the Prince Edward on the 8th of January, 2023. So be sure to book your tickets before Mary takes her final flight. So today we welcome, of course, ZZ Stroud, Charlie Stemp, Dance Captain Eve Zedang, and children's musical director Alex Aitken. So let's have a little, we'll talk first. We'll talk first, because then they've got something special planned for you, so I hope you all warmed up. So, ZZ, it's good to see you, of course, as always. So you've been playing the role for some time now, so tell us what is so special to you about getting to play Mary Poppins over and over again.
Special things about Mary Poppins. She flies, for one, and she's magical, but she's also very confident and full of love, and she brings everyone together, and that's really important.
Absolutely. Well, what keeps it exciting after so long? Like, what makes it still fresh and part of the day that you get up and you're like, yeah, let's go, let's take a flight over the audience?
I mean, for me, one of the things, I love working with the kids. They keep it fresh, we constantly change them. So for me, I get different actors on stage all the time.
It keeps it exciting, you know.
Yeah.
What's the old Hollywood saying, I never work with animals or children? You've kind of flipped that on its head.
Yeah, exactly, I love it, I'm used to it.
Charlie, my friend, it's good to see you. Lovely to see you as always. So what do you love about playing Bert?
A few things. I think the first thing is, I mean, going upside down on the Senior March is pretty cool.
Yes.
I mean, I just get to be a big kid a lot of the time as well. Like, Mary has to be very serious, has to look after the kids, and I just kind of get to run around and have fun.
I like that. And you bring that extra, you've always brought such a zest and a genuine love of life to any time you're on stage. And I think audiences can feel that. They can feel that from you. We all feel it from you. And so it's always exciting to see you perform. And I think this is a role that really allows you to explore and explode with life. And it's absolutely wonderful. So what are the challenges in this role as a performer, especially with the amount of choreography and I assume vertigo from being upside down, but you tell me.
Yeah, I mean, keeping fit is one that's sometimes tricky. It's a very demanding role. So kind of like constantly massaging, rolling out, checking the voice, checking kind of everything. But I mean, all in all, we have so much fun that once you get on the stage, those little things that you kind of worry about before, once the adrenaline hits you, you kind of don't realize, you don't worry about it because it's just gone.
Of course. So all of you young performers out there and budding performers out there, notice what he said, use the roller. As miserable as this, it's absolutely
always
your best friend. It's absolutely your best friend. So there's one last thing I wanted to talk about. So Prince Edward Theater is very dear to my heart. I made my West End debut there as the genie in Disney's Aladdin. But what's funny and what most of you do not know is Charlie and I, not only do we share, it's the same dressing room, but the same dresser in Ron.
It's Ronnie.
And he unfortunately is home with COVID right now. So if everybody could get your cameras out and film this and tag Charlie and I in it, we are all gonna send these to Ron. And, genuinely, I need everybody to say on the count of three, get well soon, Ron, okay? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3.
Get well soon, Ron!
Thank you. That meant the world to me. He's going to hate it. I hear that. Eves, please tell us about your role as a dance captain and exactly what that involves. Because for the uninitiated, what is a dance captain?
Yeah, I am the dance captain of the show. Our show is really big. We've got lots of choreography. So we're a big team of 3 people in-house. And we look after the dance in the show. So we provide the warm-up. We make sure the show stays really clean and sharp. We rehearse with the children. We've got one of our Michaels sitting in the audience as well. So we just look after the show, make sure it's always like the opening night.
Wonderful, wonderful. And I assume everyone always listens to the Dance Captain and takes their notes straight to heart. And
always, especially these two.
That's the correct answer. Well, I'm going to leave you in these very capable hands, so limber up, get ready.
All right, guys. Well, we thought, Musical Con, why don't we do a little bit of a Super Cup? But rather than us performing for you, we wanted you to join us. So make sure you've got enough space, because we are going to take you through the letters of Super Cup. Let's start. We're going to start with the letter S. Do you all have enough space? Let's start. You're going to have your right hand on top, left hand on the bottom. Curl your fingers so it's like an S shape and present it by your left hip. This is the first one. S, show us the S. Lovely, Musical Con. Nice. Keep your wrists connected and go to a U shape. That's the second one. Over your right shoulder. If you want to copy us, that's absolutely fine. Or do it over your right shoulder. So the first one is the S. Then we go to the U. The third one is the P. Make sure your left arm is straight up, and then you're gonna curl your fingers and present as the P, exactly, S-U-P. The third, but the fourth one already is the E. We wanna have three horizontal stripes, so your foot, your hand, and your other hand, and you wanna look over your right hand for the E, and then the R, you're gonna go through your mouth, and we go up to an R. That's the first five letters. Are we ready? We have. Thank you, Alex. We have S U P E R N up. Lovely, nice, well done, guys. Then we go for the C. So after we've done the R, you're gonna go to C A. So for the A, you wanna bend your legs, you wanna look down, and you wanna make a roof out of your hands, A. Then we go for the L. For the L, start with your left arm straight up, and then you're gonna give me an L. So extend your right arm, L. To finish it off, we've got the I. Lift your chest, I. And then the last one out of this block of five letters is the F. You're gonna take your right foot forward. You're gonna have two middle fingers and index fingers, and you're gonna go here. And make sure your faces are visible. Looking great, Musical Con. Nice, yes. So this block of letters is the C. Then we go to the A, we have the L, I. Then we step forward, if you've got space, F, and then we step back. Nice, what do we think, Susie Charlie? Looking good? Nice. Let's go, the first 10 letters, starting from the S. Thank you, Alex. We have S, U, P, E, R, into the R. We have C, A, L. I, F, N, back. Nice, thank you. How are we getting on? All good? Yes, lovely. We've just done the F and back. We then have the R again, so we know this letter already. R. Then A, so lean forward, present your right ear. Then we go to the G. This is a tricky one. Round your arms, make sure your knees stay connected, and we always call this the moody G, so you want to look down a little bit for the G. So we've done R, A, G, we step back, I, so make sure your arms are up, L, and this is a letter we also know already. Yeah, so there's a few we already know, nice and easy. We've got the R, A, G, I, L, and back. Nice. Lovely. Shall we add all of this together? The first 15 letters all the way from the top. Thank you, Alex. We have, yes, S, U, B, E, R, into the R. We have C, A, L, I, F, stepping forward and back. Then R, A, G, I, and nice, lovely. All good, so far so good? We'll give you a few more goes, don't you worry, eventually you'll get there. Then to finish it up, we've got IST, so it's a tricky one. We've just finished our L. Make sure your left hand goes on top, right is on the bottom. You're gonna bend your legs, you're gonna do plie, and stretch to finish in a T shape. So you wanna make sure your right arm is parallel to the floor, and we make a lovely T shape. So after the L, the last letter we've done, you've got I, S, T. Now your right hand should be on top and stays on top. Press your left hand down as you bend your legs again. Your arms unfold as you jump and then you land. So you want to show us an X without blocking your face because we want to see your lovely faces. So after the L, this new section is I, S, T, I, C, E, X. Yes? To finish it off, we go to a B. And I always think of this as having a pen and having a piece of paper. So you want to pull up to a B. And then you give us five little dots going from left all the way to the right. Yes, five dots. So after the L, this new section is I, S, T, I, C, E, X, B, I, A, L, I, D. Yes? Music gong gong. We've got five more letters. Let's finish it off. We have O. So you want to extend your right leg and you want to extend your right arm as well. Your head tilts to the right, so it's quite a tricky one. Just see how you get on. You can also just make a simpler one without the head. It's completely up to you. After our five dots, one, two, three, four, five, O, we then have the last letters. C, I, just isolate having your left hand on your chest. Then we come up, O, right hand on top. Yes, to finish it off, the U, we want to give you the letter. So you want to extend your arms forward, head goes to the left. And to finish it off, the last letter is the same one as the first, S. This time, rather than being by your hip in front of your chest, head goes to the right. And then we're done. That's it. Lovely. Nice. Let's just recap the last bit before we add everything together. So after the L, this is IST. We've got IST. I, C, E, X, B, I, A, L, I, D, O, C, I, O, U, S, and then we're done. Guys, don't you worry, we've taken weeks and weeks before we knew these letters. So if today you only get a few, that's absolutely fine. It's not about doing them all with us, but just try to do it as well as you can. We've got the lovely Alex playing for us. So why don't we just do all the letters? Let's do three times around. We start nice and slow just for our brain, and then we just challenge ourselves, and then we really challenge ourselves. Are we up for it? Yay! Nice! All right, musical phone, let's go. Thank you, Alex. We have N, S, U, V, E, R, into the R. We have C, A, I, F, N, back, R, A, G.
R, A, G, I, N.
I, S, T, here we go with the plie. I, S, T, I, C, five dots, N. One, two, three, four, five. Lovely, a little bit faster. S, U, B, E. Are looking good, guys. Keep going. C, A, L, I, F. Nice. R, A, G, I, L. Yes. I, S, T, I, C, E, X, B, I, A, L, I, D. Musical gong, are we ready for a challenge? Last time. S, U, B, E, R. Yes, looking good. C, A, L, I, F, N. R, A, G, I, L. I, S, T, I, C, E, X, B, I, A, L. Slowly. O, C, I, O, U, S. Yes, guys! Nice! Well done. That's it. Well done, guys. Have a lovely day. See you in the theater.
One more round of applause for Mary Poppins. Now, this next show holds a very special place in my heart. So a lot of us, we get into musical theater in different ways. I used to listen to cast recordings in the car with my parents. This was my mom's favorite show. It's still, my dad still loves it. So please, we are going to talk about The Phantom of the Opera. Phantom of the Opera is now celebrating its 36th anniversary in London's West End. Andrew Lloyd Webber's romantic, haunting, and soaring score includes Music of the Night, All I Ask of You, Wishing You Were Somehow Here Again, Masquerade, and of course, the iconic title song. Now, also, with the Broadway production soon closing, this West End show will be the lasting legacy of this show, and it's very important, so please continue to go out, support, and give your love for Phantom of the Opera like I will always do. The Phantom of the Opera is widely considered one of the most beautiful and spectacular productions in history, playing to over 145 million people in 41 countries, and 183 cities in 17 languages. So please, welcome to the stage the alternate Christine Holly Ann Hall! Good morning, Holly. Good morning. Hello. Good morning. How are you doing?
Yes, I'm good. There's a lot of people here.
But they're here and you're giving you lots of love, right? So, why don't you tell me, what are some of your favorite, what's your favorite moment with Christine, with the character? What's your favorite moment in the show that you get to kind of exist in?
There's a few moments I love. My favorite kind of scene in the show is All I Ask of You. Me and my friend Matt, who plays Raoul, we have such a hilarious relationship, and that's kind of the scene where we try and make each other laugh, and it's a very youthful, playful scene. And you know, the show is so heavy and emotional. It's nice to have that kind of bit of light relief.
Of course. There's so much weight to the love. And I guess obsession as well that's in the show, and the way that those two things kind of blend into each other. So I think it's always nice. The levity of that makes
just
it
just a smile.
So I hear now. Listen, it's not really my thing, but I'd love to understand because I hear you have quite a passion for TikTok dancing.
I knew this was coming. I think the thing that people love about it so much is that I am the worst TikToker in the world. All of my videos are the worst transitions and all the things. I'm working on it. If anyone has any tips and ideas for me, please share them, because if you saw my page, you'd be appalled.
Also, follow Holly Ann on TikTok. What's your talk? Is that what this
is? I think it's just my name. This is the thing. I don't even know.
Well, please enjoy as Holly sings for us Wishing from Phantom of the Opera.
Thank you.
help me say goodbye. Help me say
not only is it remarkable, the song's gorgeous and it's stunning anyway. Holly Ann's voice is fantastic, but also it's 10 o'clock in the morning. Like, she sang that at 10 o'clock in the morning, so please, one more round of applause. Phenomenal, phenomenal. Now, we've got one more show to talk about today. Hamilton. Phenomenon Hamilton tells the story of America's founding father, Alexander Hamilton. If you hadn't noticed, I'm also American. The score blends hip-hop, jazz, blues, rap, R&B, and Broadway. The story of America then as told by America now. The production is the winner of 11 Tony Awards, including Best Musical, 7 Olivier Awards, the 2016 Pulitzer Prize for Drama, and the 2016 Grammy Award for Best Musical Theater Album. And I happen to play George Washington in it currently. So please welcome to the stage my friend, my fellow cast member, King George III himself, Joel Montague!
Wow, there's a lot of people.
Joel, we did two shows last night.
You know what I mean?
We did two shows last night together. How would you describe King George as a character?
He's mental. He's actually mental. It's never been, I don't think there's been one thing in my career where I've ever wanted to play, you know, a torturous king, but he definitely is one. So he's crazy.
I feel like you unearthed some hidden part of yourself whenever you stepped into the costume
secretly,
for the first time.
Secretly, guys, let's just keep on the down low.
Nobody share that.
Yeah,
no. What do you think the impact that Hamilton has had on the landscape of musical theater in general? There's something, we had a conversation a few weeks ago. We were speaking about the show, and not necessarily the people who see the show are always the people who the show is about and who the show speaks to in the best way.
Yeah, and we do a wonderful thing at Hamilton, as Trevor would know, called Edgeham.
Yes.
Where we speak out to more underprivileged communities where they can come and see the show.
Yeah.
Because it is such a cultural phenomenon, and it's so worldwide, this show is huge. It's taken over the
world.
They
just opened in Germany. They just opened,
In Germany.
A production of Hamilton in Germany. But
it's crazy.
Edgeham is something that's been very important to me since joining the cast.
Yeah.
If anybody who knows me knows that the idea of spreading the idea of theater to schools and to students, especially ones who aren't necessarily exposed to it and seek it out like we
would have. Your kids' schools have come up, haven't they? Children's schools.
Of course. And so Edgeham's very important. So I don't want to delay too much longer for what the inevitable of what we all know is coming next. So please. Enjoy You'll Be Back by Joel Montague.
You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you heard in the sea. When you see me go by, why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back, soon you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all.
the battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say your love is draining and you can't go home. You'll be the one complaining when I am gone. And now to change the subject, cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet submissive subject, my loyal, royal subject, forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be there like before. I will fight the fight and win the war. For your love, for your praise, and I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
Shows or welcome you back to one of our shows if you've been before. I hope you've enjoyed the opening of day two of Musical Con. There is so much more for you today. Please explore, but also stay put right here because there's something very special coming up, and it's something very dear to my heart. I'm just gonna give you a little thingy, a little preview. Every year on my birthday, which is coming up very soon on the 5th of November, every year on my birthday, I watch the Back to the Future trilogy. So sit tight, and thank you so much. Have a good time, Musical Con. Thank you.